Angela Murray. We're going to go through a mixed pole routine today. So full workout with warm-up, stretch, strengthen, routine, and a little bit of stretch at the end. So let's go ahead and start on the back of your pole, holding on to the pole about waist height, come up and down on those toes. I'm just going to warm the ankles up a little bit, and then hold it at the top, circle the ankles around, and then take it in the other direction. And then hold it at the top, moving those hips side to side. So abs are nice and tight. Imagine you have a corset on and you're zipping everything up. So hips side to side. And then take those hips forward and back. So a little tuck tilt here. Just flattening that lower back out as you tuck. And then back to that side to side. Take it forward and back. And then put those two moves together. It's a big hip circle. So draw a big circle on the floor with those hips. And then take it in the other direction. One way always moves better than the other. Just kind of loosen everything up. And then bring it back to the center. Come up and down on those toes again. And then again, hold it at the top. Circle the ankles around. And reverse. Staying up on those toes. Moving the ribcage side to side now. So lower body still, just moving the ribcage. And then take that chest and pop it. So chest pop, pop, pop. Take it side to side. Forward and back. We're gonna put those two moves together. Big chest roll, pop and round. So imagine you're taking your chest or your boobs and lifting them up and over, so you get that big chest roll. Take them the other direction. And again, one way always moves better than the other. Bring it back to the center, dropping down on those heels. Again, to those hips, side to side, forward and back, and then circle those hips. Go ahead and add the chest roll with it. So hips and chest, sometimes it's a little harder, sometimes it's easier, but just loosening that spine, circling around. We're gonna go the other way. Again, hip and chest, hip and chest. Go ahead and come up on those toes. We're gonna take a dip now. So you're gonna squat down the center, scooping up one side, down the center, and scoop up the other. So it's a little squat and scoop, you want to make sure you're pivoting the knees and toes with you in each direction. And then hold this one at the top. Circle again, hip and chest. And this time I want you to sink into it. So staying up on the toes, all your weight sits back. Circle it back up. Bring it back down. Back up top. We're going to go for those dips again, side to side. Again. All the way up top. Right hand nice and high. We're going to take a walk around that pole. And then stopping on the side, circle the hips here. Take that outside leg, so the leg furthest from the pole, half circles around. So as if you're carving through that floor, all the weight's on the inside leg. And then add a shoulder roll with it. So you can trace down that leg as you roll. One more time, and then you're gonna lift that knee up. We're rolling it back, open the chest and hip, just loosening those joints here. One more time, and then rolling it forward. Big up and over. There you go, last one. Take a walk, hand nice and high. We're gonna stop on the back of the pole this time, facing the front. Little twist, you're just stepping one foot right over top of the other. And then peel those legs out wide. So one, two, back to those circles, hip and chest here. Take them low, sink into it. Come back up, take it low again. Back up top, back to those dips, side to side. Squat and scoop, again, pivot the knees and toes. Bring this all the way up top. Left arm this time, taking a walk around. When you get to the side, you're gonna stop. Hold it there for those hip circles. Take that outside leg, that half circle. So again, carving through the floor with that outside leg, all the weight on the inside leg, add the shoulder roll with it. One more here, grab that knee, roll it back, open the chest and hip, loosening those joints up. Now roll it forward, up and over, One more time. Take a walk, hand high. Next time around, I want you to stop on the front of the pole, turn under the arm, that pirouette, back on the pole, peel the legs out wide. Legs nice and wide, hips open, tuck the pelvis under so abs are tight, take it down for that plié squat. Try to get the knees over those toes, lower back nice and flat up against the pole so abs are super tight here. One more time, take it down. You're gonna drop the heels, both hands up top. Drop that right leg, bring the hands to the floor. So now you're on all fours right here. Big vertical circle, pushing that floor away. So hands right under the shoulders, push the floor away, big cat stretch at the top. Take it in the other direction, down and around, two more. Last time, hold it right there. Curl those toes under. You're gonna push back into a down dog. So you're pushing the floor away. Float those hips up towards the ceiling. Alternate a couple knee bends here. And then walk those hands out. So you're in that push-up position here. Pushing the floor away. Slow lower, everything nice and tight. Elbows in tight to the body. Big push back up. Drop it down again, nice and slow. Big push up. Walk those hands back. Roll that body up. Take that body roll down. So you're going down, roll it up again. One more time. Drop it down, roll it all the way back up. Left arm, taking a walk, nice and high with that hand. Stopping on the front again, turn under that arm, that pirouette, out wide here. Lower back pushed into the pole, abs tight, knees right over those ankles. Take it down and up, those pliés. Again. Last one, hold it down. Take the left leg this time, drop it down. Both hands come to the floor. Big vertical circle again, push that floor away. Big circle, push, cat stretch at the top. And go in the other direction, down and around. And again, two more. Last one, hold this one at the top. Curl those toes under, push back to that down dog again. You're pushing the floor away, floating the hips to the ceiling, alternate some knee bends. And then walk it back out to that push-up position. Hands right under the shoulders, body nice and tight. Lower it down, elbows in, big push. Again, lower down, big push-up. One more time, hold it at the top. Walk those hands back. Roll that body up. Take that body roll again. Down and up. Again. One more time. All the way up. Take a walk. Left hand. Stopping on the side of your pole. Side stretch here. So both palms on the backside. Feet are close to the base. Let those hips drop out to the side as you open that chest and shoulder. Feel that stretch. Pull it in and drop it out. Again. Hold this one out there. Ah, feels so good. Pull it back in. Facing the pole. Round the back. Tuck those hips under. Big back stretch here. So really tuck everything under. Push the back to the ceiling. Pull those shoulder blades apart. Roll this stretch all the way up. Cross them over to the other side. Palms on the back, feet are close to the base. Drop those hips out, open that chest, feel that side stretch. Pull it back in, drop it back out. Pull it back in, drop it back out. Hold it here. Turn it in to face that pole. Legs a little wider, back stretch again. Hands are low, round that back, tucking those hips under. You can move up and down with this, rolling that stretch up and down the back. Roll it all the way up. Step out wide to the side. Big shoulder rolls here. Rolling those shoulders back. Last one, now forward, up and over, up and over. Last time, big inhale. Exhale down. Again, up and down. All righty. Ready to move into some strength. So we're gonna face our pole, and you're gonna take those feet just ahead of the base. And then you're gonna sit down as if you were gonna sit in an imaginary chair, and you're gonna pinch the pole right in between those legs. So it's right above the knee, squeezing the inner thighs. I want you to try to get the knee and hip in a straight line. So not up here, not way down here. You're trying to get that knee and hip in that straight line. So I'm squeezing the inner thighs. I'm gonna wrap an arm, maybe another. Stay right here. All the weight is sitting into my butt, weight into the heels. Toes can come off the floor. So heels, stay there, stay there. You're squeezing those inner thighs. So squeeze that pole, pinch the pole right in between those legs. Walk those hands back up, shake it out. All right, so this time, we're gonna stay into the right foot. So I'm gonna stand on that right foot, take that left leg, kick it, and then I'm gonna take a big lunge back. Now when you do, make sure that knee stays right over that ankle. So I'm here, chest up, leg, back leg's nice and long, feel a stretch here in the hip. Shift the weight into that right foot and kick. So it's a lunge and kick. Again, lunge and kick, lunge and kick. Last time, take that leg back, stay right here. All the weight in that right leg, tuck that back hip under a little bit, feel that stretch right here. Now I want you to step, kick, and hold. So I'm gonna kick that leg out, I'm gonna sink into that right leg. So all my weight's in that right foot, holding that left leg out there, bring the hands low, shoulders are down. Woo, feel it in the right leg, come back up. All right, shake it out. So shifting the weight into the left leg, step, kick, and lunge. So weight right here in the left side, step, kick, lunge it back, step, kick, lunge it back, again. One more time, hold that leg back there, stay here, knee over that ankle, stretch in the right hip, so I'm gonna tuck that back hip under, feeling that stretch right along the front of the right hip. Now step, kick, and hold. So I step into the left foot, kick and hold. All my weight's sitting right here. Bring the hands low. Woo! Step it up. Shake it up. Come back to that pole again. So I'm gonna bring the legs, feet just ahead of the pole. I'm gonna sit again, pinching the pole just above the knees. So those inner thighs are squeezing tight, tight, tight. Squeeze, squeeze. Bring the hands low. Wrap those elbows. All the weight's sitting into my butt. Heels pushed into the floor, toes come off. Little shake side to side. Squeezing the inner thighs, feeling the legs, and then stay here. You're gonna shift the weight into the right. Kick that left leg out. Hold, 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 hold. Switch, all the weight into the left, kick the right foot out. Hold, 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 hold. Bring it back up. Shake it out. All right, so. Taking your right leg, hook the front of the pole. So I want that hip and knee in line. Heel is gonna squeeze tight to my butt. Let's make that hamstring nice and strong. I'm gonna open that standing hip up. Hip should be right over top of that foot. Tighten everything up here as I lean out to the side. So I'm gonna try to get flat. Knee, hip, shoulder, nice straight line. That front hip should be pushed forward. So if I turn to the side, you can see where I am here. Pushing that forward, nice and flat. So I'm gonna tip that out to the side. All my weight's here, driving that foot into the floor. Reach long, you're lengthening, lengthening. Reach, reach, and then I crunch elbow to butt. So I reach long, lengthen, and strengthen. Again, reach, and crunch. So we're gonna add some flowy arms to this. I'm gonna reach out and then flow back. Reach out with the top arm, flow back. Again. So I'm crunching, feeling it in the standing leg, feeling it in the hooked leg, that hamstring, and definitely in that side waist. Last one, grab that pole, drop it off. Let's switch to the other side. Hook that left leg nice and high on the pole. Heels squeezing again, tight to the butt. Standing leg's gonna open up. Drive that foot into the floor. As you lay out to the side, you're gonna push that top hip forward. So you shouldn't be bent at the hip here. You wanna really push that hip forward. Knee, hip, shoulder, nice straight line all the way down. Reach long here, lengthen, lengthen. Now strengthen and crunch. Reach long, lengthen, strengthen. So you're crunching, bringing that elbow to your butt. Again. Two more times. Let's see if we can add that flow. So I'm gonna reach and flow. Reach the top arm, flow it back. Again. You got it. Hold it up top, shake it out. All right, come back around. Just giving that all a break. Take your hands nice and high. We're gonna take the right hand high on the pole. Left hand's gonna go just below it. We're gonna go basic climb here. So that right leg comes into that high march position. Top of the foot touches the pole, knee just out to the side. You're shoving that pole on the floor as you bring that step up to stand. So again, you're squeezing the inner thighs super tight. Remember that internal rotation that's happening. You can adjust if you need to. If you have room at home to climb up a little higher, okay? So hands are always gonna come low, so we're making those legs work. Add a little side to side maybe. Reach, reach. Now when you're reaching, remember you're keeping your body close to the pole. So you're actually kind of reaching in a V. That's gonna keep you on the pole, okay? Then we're gonna slide down and switch. So left hand nice and high. Left leg comes in that high march. Again, shove the pole on the floor as you step up. Get those legs nice and long on the pole so you have full contact. Squeeze those inner thighs. When you're ready, reach, reach. Maybe you're able to let go all the way, but again, you're finding that reach that's in a V, okay? So you're not just coming right off the pole. Go ahead and bring that down. All right. So when we do our routine, we're gonna have a climbing pose. We're gonna use that climb. You can do the stand and reach if you're able to do a sit or some pose you want to plug in there. I'm not going to teach a pose, but I want you to do a climbing pose and then a descent, okay? Wherever that leads you, okay? So your descend, make sure that your shoulders are always back and down. You're shoving that pole on the floor. So you want to pop the chest, shoulder, back and down. So if I take that climb up, let's say I'm just gonna go to a pole stand and I'm going to reach. Maybe I can let go with both arms, add a little flow. Maybe I wanna take it to a sit. Maybe I wanna take it to a more intermediate or advanced pose. Whatever that is, then I'm going to roll the shoulders back and down. That narrow grip, one hand stacked right over top, shove the pole on the floor. So I'm gonna pop the chest, squeeze the back, release those legs. Some pretty descend. The shoulders should be pulled back and down. So what I want you to think is back and shoulders on your descent. We'll go through it. I'll remind you as we go through. So another thing I want to go through here, kind of as a strength, but it's also going to come into our routine, those plie squats we did. I'm going to do them kind of on an angle here, but I want you to make sure that you can get your back on the pole. So I'm going to tuck those hips under. Your feet should be a little bit further from the pole. So what I mean is I don't want you standing right up against the pole here. You're gonna take those legs a little wide and away from the pole. So that when you tuck those hips under, that flat back is pushed into the pole, that you're not arched here with a space, okay? So I'm here, I'm gonna take it down. So I push my back into the pole, take those plie squats, down and up. Now when you're doing those, you also want your back to the pole, but you want those knees over those ankles. So I don't wanna be in too close here so that when I go over, I'm too far. I want the knee to end up pretty much right over those ankles. So abs are nice and tight. I'm squeezing the butt cheek and the inner thigh on the way up. Yes, all the way, all right? So go back to your left side of your pole. You're gonna take your right leg high on the pole. So those abs that we did with the flowy arms, we're gonna use those in our routine. So again, it's important to find that balance with your form. So heel to the butt, standing leg, balanced right over top of that foot. You're opening that hip up a little bit. So we're going to push that top hip forward as we reach out, nice and long. We're going to flow back up. And again, reach and flow. One more time. Now that inside arm is going to grab the pole. You drop that inside leg as you slide yourself across the front of the pole. Tuck everything under. Take those plie squats. And you can adjust that wrist up here if you need to. But you're going to take it down for three. Here's two. Last one, whatever hand we're on, so your right arm should be the high hand, you're going to turn that opposite direction because the right leg is then going to step up into a climb. So if I turn to the left, that right foot steps right up onto the pole, ready to climb. Top of the foot touching the pole, shove the pole on the floor, climb it up to whatever height I'm ready for, take that pose, whatever your climbing pose is going to be today. And then you're gonna use that narrow grip, shoulders back and down, and descend. All right? So let's try that part again. Right leg's gonna hook nice and high. Heel to the butt, open it up, reach it out. Flow again. One more time. Inside arm grabs the pole, inside leg drops down. Three plie squats. Three, two, last one. Turn to the left. Right leg, right up on the pole, step it up to that climb. Reach, take your pose, wherever you want to be, and then that narrow grip, shoulders back and down, bring it down, okay? Let's look at it on the other side. So left leg's going to hook nice and high, heel tight to the butt, standing leg's going to open. Again, it should be right underneath that hip. Tighten the waist as you reach out, push that top hip. Reach, reach, flow back up. Again, reach it out, flow back up. Again, inside arm grabs the pole, so that left arm, drop that inside leg, slide your body across the pole, tuck those hips, three plies. Down, again, here's two, last time. Now we're pivoting to the right. So the left leg is ready to step up to climb. Let's look at that again. Left leg hooks, reach and flow. Reach it out, flow it back. Again, one more time. Inside arm, inside leg drops. Three plie squats. Knees over those ankles, abs tight. Here's two, last one. Pivot right, left leg, ready to step up to climb. So wherever that climbing pose is for you, I'll come down a little bit. Get out of the camera. Okay, wherever you want to be. Narrow grip, shoulders back and down. Bring it down. Okay. One more time, left side. Left leg hooks, heel to butt, standing leg open. Reach it out, flow back. Here's two. One more. Inside arm, inside leg. Plie, take it down. Three, two, last one. Pivot right, left leg steps up, ready to climb. Adjust and squeeze, reach, maybe a sit, maybe a pose, whatever you want to add in there. Narrow grip, shoulders back and down, bring it down. Alrighty. So that's one part of our routine. Let's go to the very beginning of it. We're going to use the elbow dance turn. So take your right arm nice and high. Inside leg opens up to face the pole. You want that knee and toe facing the pole, hip open. Outside leg out to the side. Remember, let your body weight always hang off the pole. Big distance between you and the pole. As I tip, that outside leg's gonna draw a big circle around. The foot replaces this one. My outside arm's gonna wrap. It's called an elbow dance turn, but it's really a forearm wrap. So here it is in slow motion, come with me. Outside leg, I tip around. Plant that foot replacement, wrap the forearm on the pole. You actually then come up on that standing foot. The weight of that back leg or lifted leg is going to tip you back until you're in a straddle resting on the pole. So the inside hip, that leg is then going to lift, you untangle and twist and step. So the hands never change. They're exactly where they should be. Hand nice and high. Outside leg. Tip, tip, plant. Lift the other leg. Come up on the toes. Wrap that forearm. Let the weight of that leg tip back to that straddle. Inside leg lifts. Push that pull away. And untangle. So you're landing with an outside foot. You're going to step on that. The inside foot is going to reach. You're going to kind of tip and reach. Because that inside leg is going to wrap the front of the pole and put us right to that reach and flow that we did a few minutes ago. So let's look at it again, right side. So that elbow dance turn, outside leg, swing and plant, foot replace, wrap the arm, pivot back, pivot back, pivot back. Inside leg comes up, pivot, step. Now that right leg is your inside leg, it's going to extend. You're giving yourself some distance from the pole so that leg can wrap around and hook. And again, knee and hip, standing leg, we reach and flow. Here again. One more time. Then we grip that inside arm. Inside leg drops off. Three pliés. Down and up. Again. Last one. Pivot to the left. Right leg steps up to climb. Shove the pole in the floor. Reach, flow, pose, wherever you're going to be. Come back down. Okay? Let's see if we can go through on the left side. Left hand nice and high, inside leg open, outside leg out to the side. Body weight again, hanging off the pole. Outside leg comes around the pole to foot replace. Outside leg, tip, plant, foot replace, wrap the right arm. Come up on the standing toe. The weight of that top leg tipping back puts you into that straddle. Inside leg lifts, and I pivot back around. All right, let's look at that again over here. Hand nice and high, outside leg, tip, tip, plant, wrap and lift. Let the weight of that leg pull you back. Inside leg comes up, push away, and plant. So remember, that right leg now is my outside leg. So I'm gonna step on that foot so that I can reach and clear with that left leg that hooks for my reach and flow. Again, left hand nice and high. Inside leg open, tip, tip, plant, elbow dance turn, wrap and lift. Continue to pivot. Inside leg comes up. I pivot around, step, reach and clear so that inside leg, left leg hooks. Adjust the standing foot if you need before you reach and flow. Again. One more time. Now that inside arm, left arm grabs. Inside leg, left leg slides down. Three big pliés. Three, two, last one. Pivot right, left leg steps up to climb. Climbing pose, wherever that is. Narrow grip, bring it down. All right, let's go back to the right arm. Inside leg open, outside leg out to the side. Tip, 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 elbow dance turn, plant. Lift that foot, wrap that arm, pivot. Inside leg comes up, pivot around. Step, right leg clears and hooks. Reach and slow, again. One more time, grab that pole, slide that inside leg down, three pliés. Again, last one, pivot left, right leg on the pole, climb it up. Pose, wherever you're going to be with that, give you plenty of time, narrow grip, roll it down. Okay, let's go to the left side. Left hand nice and high, inside leg open, outside leg out to the side, tip, 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 elbow dance turn, plant, wrap. Pivot, inside leg comes up, step, right leg, left leg reaches, and it hooks. Reach and flow. Again, One more. Grab that pole. Left leg drops down. Three pliés. Two more. Last one. Pivot to the right, left leg on the pole to climb. Squeeze, reach. Whatever your pose is gonna be, roll those shoulders down to descend. All right, swipe your pole if you need to, get a drink. The next part, we're gonna go into our dance turn. So with the dance, with the spin, we're gonna use reverse double attitude, which starts the same as the elbow dance turn that we just did. So let's go on our right arm. Inside leg opens up to face the pole. Outside leg out to the side. That body weight again is really hanging away from the pole. Outside leg is gonna swing and plant just like we do with the elbow dance turn. Foot replaces, lift that other leg, wrap the arm. From this position, you're gonna come up on the toe. So everything so far is the same as the elbow dance turn, except that top leg is just gonna whip back, heel to butt. I'm gonna turn this way a second so you can see what I just did. That leg whips back, heel to butt. That's your momentum that's gonna tip you into the spin. So that whipping motion, heel to butt, is gonna tip you, power you. No jumping, you're just letting your body fall back. And as you do so, you're gonna tip back. The standing leg is gonna pull up into that attitude position as well. So it's a double attitude leg, and you're going backwards. Here it is in real motion. Outside leg, I tip and plant. Whip that leg back as I wrap the arm, and I drag those legs right back to the floor. So my legs end up in that double attitude position. My chest is facing the pole. The knees are facing forward as well. Don't flip the knees the other way. Doesn't matter if they end up kind of stacked as well, that's okay. As long as the knees are still facing in and your chest is facing in. So you'll end up kind of hugging into that pole. Let's try it again together. Come back up. Outside leg, swing and plant. Wrap that arm, lift the leg, let it pull you back. Attitude legs. Okay? So again, we finish hugging into that pole. The momentum comes from we swing and plant, but this leg whipping back. And as that happens, if you come up on that toe and allow yourself to pivot, the weight of your body is going to just pull you right down. Okay? You can drag those legs with you, you could lift them up. Let's try the left arm. Left arm nice and high, inside leg open, outside leg out to the side. Again, you're gonna slow motion here, tip, 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 plant, wrap that arm, whip that top leg back, heel to butt, as you come up on the standing toe. That's gonna allow you to pivot backwards. Those legs are gonna drag and fold into that double attitude. Again, you're hugging into the pole, or your chest should face the pole. Knees are facing in. Doesn't matter if they're stacked a little bit or they're really kind of split. Let's come back up. Left arm again. Hand nice and high. Inside leg open, outside leg out to the side. Tip and plant. Wrap that arm. Let your body pull you back. That attitude. Yes. Okay. Coming back up. Let's look at it on the right side. Adding that momentum. Just make sure that you don't jump because you're gonna kind of jolt your shoulders. And also when you're getting into your spin, and that's all spins and dance turns, make sure those shoulders are pulled back and down. So when I swing and plant and I wrap right here, this wrapped arm is just kind of catching my body weight on the pole. So as my body hangs away, it's catching with that forearm. I don't want to hang on my shoulders, so I want to make sure this top arm is really kind of shoving the pole on the floor, and you're pulling that shoulder back and down, so that you're not just hanging and dangling on that shoulder, okay? So stay strong through there. I always like to say, imagine you have big earrings on, you're trying to show those off. If you're feeling strong with this and you want to take it up a notch, then you can add a little more oomph in your whip back. Remember, your momentum comes from how much you whip back and fall back. That power naturally pulls you away from the pole. So that wrapped arm, you could change that to kind of a push arm. So it's just the palm pushing that pole away, thumbs up. You don't want to grip because you tend to pull in, but you're going to think push away. You might even be able to hover that hand off. And as you start to slow down, then you would have to start to push to keep the distance from you and the pole. So that's going to look like this. I add some momentum by walking. When I'm ready, I take that big swing and plant, whip it back. I can kind of float off here and push that palm away when I need to. All right. Try and spin on your left side. You can stay with option one with it or option two if you're adding a little bit more oomph, maybe that push. So walk into it. Again, pull that shoulder back and down when you're ready. Outside legs, swing and plant, wrap and whip. Until you finish right here. So let's stay here a second, moving on. So the inside hand is gonna come to the floor right under the shoulder, spread the fingers nice and wide. You're pushing into the floor. The inside leg, which is the leg closest to the pole, should be your right leg right now. You're gonna kick that leg forward. I shove the pole on the floor with the hand on the pole, and I push into the floor with the hand on the floor. All my weight's gonna go on that inside foot. As I lift myself up, again, I'm shoving the pole on the floor, lifting with that top hand, pushing into the floor with the bottom, all the weight is in that right leg. I'm gonna toss that left leg over into a lunge. Use the pole, pull yourself back up. So you're in this lunge position here. The back leg is gonna give a kick, and I'm gonna sit right on the pole. So I'm squeezing the inner thighs, pinching the pole in between the legs. I can add some little wavy kicks here. Fold one leg down so it taps the floor so that you can slide down. Butt sits on the floor, then we're gonna take those arms out to the side as you lay right on back. All right. Dropping your legs, you're gonna clear the pole to one side. Doesn't matter to which side, but I clear that pole, I roll over, hands by the chest, you're gonna float that butt back, so that snake back. Remember, heavy, heavy head and chest. You let those forearms drop to the floor to help push you back. And then you're sitting on the side of the pole, ready to grip the pole for that sexy up. Booty up, okay? So let's look at that. Spin right arm. Walk into it. Reverse double attitude when you're ready. Outside legs, swing and plant. Wrap. Let yourself whip back. All right. Inside arms, that's that left arm now, pushes into the floor. Right arm shoving the pole on the floor. Inside leg extends. Push, pull, lift those hips up. Toss that back leg, that right leg over. Find that lunge, coming up, step into that right leg, kick, sit and pinch. So I'm squeezing those inner thighs, you can kind of cross the center line with that body with those legs. And then if you want to add some wavy legs here, you can. You could reach and flow, wherever you want to go with that. And then you drop a toe to the floor, that allows you to let yourself come off. Reach it out, lay it back. Again, clear the pole, roll it over, hands by the chest, float that butt back, use those forearms, push, push, grip the pole, coming up, sexy up here, booty up, and you're ready to go again. Let's go through right side. That rollover on the floor, there's another option that's a shoulder rollover. If you haven't done a shoulder rollover yet, I'm going to break it down a little bit, but practice it by itself separately, and then you can maybe plug it in. So I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time on it, but I know some of you out there have done the shoulder rollover, and I want you to be able to have that option to put it into your routine. So let's look at that, those two options. So that reverse double attitude, I swing and plant, wrap that arm, whip the leg back. inside arm comes down. Pull and push. Kick that inside leg out. Back leg, right leg tosses over. Lunge. Step kick. Some wavy legs here. Plant one foot so that you can come down. Reach it out. So option one, we rolled over. Option two, you're going to do your shoulder roll over. So whatever hand is your dominant hand, that one's going to go overhead, fingers to the floor. Opposite hand is going to go somewhere out to the side, palm on the floor. I'm rolling over the opposite shoulder. So if my right arm is the hand up, I'm rolling over the left shoulder. It's usually your non-dominant side. So I'm going to bring those legs up. I can use the pole to push off. Make sure you have some clearance there. But I'm going to push off. I'm not rolling over my neck. I'm rolling over the shoulder only. So I'm rolling over my left shoulder here. Drop that knee. I come forward, ready to lunge into my sexy up. All right. Well, look at that. Just that shoulder rollover part again to go over here. So when you're rolling over, dominant hand, fingertips to the floor, shoulder rollover hand, that hand comes palm to the floor. I bring those legs up, I'm rolling over the opposite shoulder. Drop that knee to that shoulder, pivot that leg around, lunge, up, booty up. Okay. Let's look at the spin from the left side. Walking around. Reverse double attitude. When you're ready, outside leg swing and plant. Wrap, tip back. Right hand inside to the floor. Outside hands on top. Kick that inside leg forward. Push, pull, lift those hips. Step it over into that lunge. Step kick. Sit, pedal those legs, bring one foot to the floor, drop the butt down, reach it out. Option one, we clear that pole and roll over for that snake back. Option two, that shoulder roll over. So again, dominant hand can go up top, opposite hand, that's the shoulder you're rolling over, is going down by the side, palm to the floor. I roll over that shoulder, so I'm gonna drop my knee to that shoulder. So I bring those legs up, I can push off the pole. Knee to the shoulder. Knee to the shoulder. I clear, lunge towards the pole. Bring those toes up, and that booty up to come up, all right? Let's go through the whole routine. We'll go through right and left several times, give you enough time to add in any options. Remember, you have that climb and pose option. You have the option on the floor to do that shoulder rollover or the rollover and snake back. So wipe your pole if you need to. Let's get ready to go from the beginning. We'll run through a couple times, and then you're on your own to practice the rest. And as you're practicing at home, you can add in, build your routine. You can add in some more poses. If you're inverting already, maybe you could add a climb and invert, and then bring that back down, and then continue to flow through. Adding in and just building into it, so it gives you a good base to go through. Let's start right arm. We're gonna walk into it. So walking around, we're gonna start off with that elbow dance turn. So next time, get ready. Outside leg steps around, wrap that arm, lift, straddle back. Inside leg comes up, step, reach, right leg's gonna hook. Reach and flow, reach it out, flow it back. Again, one more time. Right arm grabs that pole, drop that right leg. Three big pliés here, down and up. Two, last one. Pivot left, right leg steps up to climb. Reach and pose. You can sit, add in whatever you're gonna do here, so whatever option you're working on. Narrow grip, shoulders back and down, bring it down. Right arm nice and high, taking that walk around. Ready for our spin, reverse double attitude. Outside leg, swing and plant. Pivot back. Left hand to the floor. Left leg extends, right leg steps over. Lunge, step, kick, and wave those legs. Bringing it down, all the way. Reach it back. Clear that pole, roll over, or that shoulder roll over, hands by the chest, float it back. Grabbing that pole, sexy up here. All the way. Take a walk. We're gonna be switching to that left arm. If you're already there, stay there. Feel it out wide on the back. Little breather here. Circle, circle. Give you time if you have to wipe your hands or wipe your pole. Well, let's go, left side, taking a walk. Elbow turn, outside leg, swing and plant, wrap, pivot back. Inside leg comes up, step, reach with that left leg, hook. So left leg's hooked, reach and flow. Reach it out, flow it back. Again. One more. Grab that pole, drop that leg. Three pliés, down and up. Again. Last one. Pivot right, left leg steps on the pole. Step up to climb, squeeze, pose here. Wherever you're taking it. Grab that pole, narrow grip, shoulders back and down, release. Left arm, taking a walk. Reverse double attitude, swing and plant, pivot back. Right hand to the floor, right leg extends. Lift, step it over to that lunge. Kick, wavy legs, toe to the floor, drop it down, laying back, clear that pole to roll over, or if you're choosing that shoulder roll over, remember the shoulder you're rolling over, lunge, sexy up, gonna go through again, so right arm nice and high, taking a little breather on the back, give you a second to wipe your pole if you need to. Circle here. Here we go, right side, take a walk. All right, elbow dance turn, outside leg, swing and plant, pivot back. Inside leg comes up, step, reach with that right leg, hook. Reach and flow, reach it out, flow. Again, one more time. Grab that pole, drop that inside leg. Three pliés here, down and up. Abs in, back push to the pole. Last one, going left, right leg on that pole. Step it up, climb. Here's your climbing pose. What are you gonna do? Can you add on? Hanging out. Narrow grip, grab that pole, bring it down. Right arm, take a walk. Reverse double attitude when you're ready. Outside leg, swing and plant, pivot back. Left hand to the floor, left leg extends, push those hips, lunge, step kick, wavy legs, bring it down, toe to the floor, drop, lay it back, clear that pole and roll over, or that shoulder roll over, float that body back, coming up sexy up here, left hand, taking a walk, stop on the back. Little breather again. Chance to wipe your pole. Gone through one more time, left side. Here we go, left arm, take a walk. Elbow dance turn, outside leg, swing and plant, wrap, pivot. Inside leg comes up, step, reach for that left leg, hook, reach and flow. Again, one more time. Grab that pole, drop that inside leg. Three plie squats here, back pushed into the pole, abs tight. Here's two, last one, pivot right, left leg on that pole, step it up to climb. Pose, again, wherever you're going with it. Have you been able to add on? Hanging out, narrow grip, bring it down. Left arm, take a walk. Reverse double attitude, swing and plant, wrap that arm, let yourself flow down. Right hand to the floor, right leg extends, Push those hips up, step it over. Lunge, grip, kick. Waving those legs. Ready to come down, toe to the floor, drop it, lay it out. Either clear that pull and roll over or that shoulder roll over. Lunge, sexy up. Good job. So run through it as often as you want. Repeat, repeat, repeat. Add in, add in, add in. Let's take a walk as we cool down here together. Stopping on the side. Feel those legs out wide. Circles here, nice and easy, hip and chest. And take those dips side to side. Again. Hold this one at the top. Right arm, take a walk. Stopping on the side again. Peel it out wide. This time take a body wave. So chest, abs, hips. Chest, abs, hips. Last one. Walk those hands down. Take a little stretch in those legs here. Shifting your weight into each hip, each foot. And then walk it right back up. Take a step closer. Round that back, that big back stretch. Keep moving with it. Roll it all the way up. Big shoulder rolls back. Back and down. And then forward, up and over. One more. Stay right here on the side, palms on the back, feet close to the base. Drop that body out, bend that inside leg, that big side stretch. Looking up towards the ceiling, open the chest. And then cross the other side. Palms on the back, feet close to the base, drop those hips out. And then pull it back in. Let's slide our backside onto the pole, legs wide. Both hands up top, thumbs down. Keep your butt there, but let your chest push forward. So really pushing that sternum. Push through each shoulder maybe, whatever feels good. And then coming back in, re-grip that pole low, thumbs down. This time let your body lean away and roll those shoulders back and down, lifting the chest. You can swivel those hips a little bit. And then pull it back in. Come across the front. Big inhale here. Exhale down. Inhale again. Exhale all the way. Good job, ladies. Thanks for joining me. Good luck with your practice.